aren't compelled to loan your car to anyone who wants it, but you are compelled to surrender your school-age child to strangers who possess children for a livelihood, even though 1 in every 9 school children is terrified of physical harm happening to them in school, terrified with good cause.
We found a disturbing number of recent school shooters were either on medication or were experiencing withdrawal.
If I demanded you give up your television to an anonymous itinerant repairman who needed work, you'd think I was crazy. If I came with a policeman who forced you to pay that repairman even after he broke your set, you would be outraged. So why are you so docile when you give up your child to a government agent called the school teacher? I want to open up concealed aspects of modern schooling, such as the deterioration it forces in the morality of parenting. You have no say at all in choosing your teachers. You know nothing about their backgrounds or families. And the state knows little more than you do. This is as radical a piece of social engineering as the human imagination can conceive. What does it mean? One thing you do know is how unlikely it will be for any teacher to understand the personality of your particular child or anything significant about your family, culture, religion, plans, hopes, dreams. In the confusion of school affairs, even teachers so disposed don't have the opportunity to know those things. How did this happen? Before you hire a company to build a house, you would, I expect, insist on detailed plans showing what the finished structure was going to look like. Building a child's mind and character is what public schools do. Their justification for prematurely breaking family and neighborhood learning. Where is the documentary evidence to prove this assumption that trained and certified professionals do it better than people who know and love them can? There isn't any. The cost in New York State for building a well-schooled child in the year 2000 is $200,000 per body when lost interest is calculated. That capital sum invested in the child's name over the past 12 years would have delivered $1 million to each kid as a nest egg to compensate for having no school. The original $200,000 is more than the average home in New York costs. You wouldn't build a home without some idea of what it would look like when finished, but you are compelled to let a core of perfect strangers tinker with your child's mind and personality without the foggiest idea what they want to do with it. Law courts and legislatures have totally absolved school people from liability. You can sue a doctor for malpractice, not a school teacher. Every home builder is accountable to customers years after the home is built, not school teachers though. You can't sue a priest, a minister, or rabbi either. That should be a clue. If you can't be guaranteed even minimal results by these institutions, not even physical safety, if you can't be guaranteed anything except that you'll be arrested if you fail to surrender your kid, just what does the public in public schools mean?